Today we will be looking at two FruitLook moisture parameters. Firstly, we will look at what these two evapotranspiration parameters are. FruitLook helps farmers understand their crop's water use through these three moisture parameters. Actual evapotranspiration tells you how much water is used to produce crops each week. It is the sum of the amount of water that is lost through crop, cover crop, and or weed transpiration, as well as the water evaporated from the soil surface. It thus represents the actual amount of water lost in the crop production process, and it is expressed in millimeters per week. Peak values are typically reached in midsummer, but greatly depend on plant physiology and management. Evapotranspiration deficit is the difference between the optimal and actual evapotranspiration for a given area and is a representation of plant water stress. So where the actual evapotranspiration is the real crop water use on a certain day, the optimal evapotranspiration would represent the amount of water that could be evaporated and transpired under actual meteorological conditions and ample water supply. The difference is the absolute evapotranspiration deficit and reflects the crop's shortfall in what it can potentially achieve. It is also expressed in millimeters per week. How does actual evapotranspiration work? It can vary between no or little evapotranspiration, all the way up to 55 millimeters per week. Common values for deciduous fruits grown in the Western Cape are between 15 and 45 millimeters per week. It is normally lower at the beginning and end of the season, as crop development is respectively just initiated or over its peak. Climatic conditions also influence the actual evapotranspiration, as we can see in this typical curve. Solar energy is more abundant in midsummer than in spring and fall, causing more evapotranspiration of water. However, there are also small variations in production from week to week. These are most likely caused by variation in meteorological conditions. For example, the following conditions can increase the potential for evapotranspiration: an increase in air temperature, a decrease in relative humidity, clear or sunny conditions, and windy conditions. How does evapotranspiration deficit work? Very hot or dry air can cause an ET deficit to occur. In this curve, we can see that a high ET deficit can occur over a number of consecutive weeks. This suggests that the soil is drying out, the plants are possibly experiencing stress, and irrigation applications are possibly lagging behind. No ET deficit suggests favorable or wet conditions. The difference will be explained in the next video, so please keep a lookout for part 2 of evapotranspiration. In the meantime, if you have any questions, you're more than welcome to contact us.